Good morning, Vaqueros. Today is Monday, November 27th, and it is currently 61 degrees outside. We are coming to you live from our Edinburgh studio. I am Kevin Alamon.
And I'm Amira Garcia.
And this is Vaquero News.
You're listening to Vaquero Radio, the Valley Student Station.
November 1st marked the beginning of a 60-day no-refusal period in Hidalgo County. What does this mean? Here is Timothy Chapman with the details.
In an effort to curb the growing number of drunk drivers, Hidalgo County law enforcement departments will enforce a no-refusal policy for the remainder of the year. The law states that individuals who are pulled over and suspected of driving while under the influence of alcohol have the right to refuse a breathalyzer or field sobriety test. However, with the 60-day no-refusal policy, drivers who refuse the test could result in officers going to extensive lengths to prove intoxication. With methods such as getting blood warrants, these can be taken from a suspect under force if need be. Edinburgh Assistant Chief of Police, Michael Cerda, said Edinburgh is a no-refusal city all year round and explained what steps officers follow when dealing with someone suspected of being intoxicated.
We will be able to have access to judges so that we can get a warrant for your blood or for your breath, mostly your blood, based off of the symptoms of intoxication that we see.
Patrol Lieutenant Primitivo Rodriguez Jr. said last year Edinburgh had 342 DWI arrests with 3 fatalities. This year, as of November 8th, the total number of DWIs is 339 with 12 deaths.
So we're already projected, probably by the end of this weekend, we're going to surpass our numbers from last year. So we have a problem, and we need to focus on trying to reduce this in whatever way we can, because we're trying to save lives.
Lieutenant Gabriel Villarina said the most frustrating part of this particular crime is that it's simply a wrong choice.
It's 100% preventable. It's a really bad choice that can lead to consequences, and as long as we don't get it out of our heads, it's not going to happen to me. We're going to continue seeing these type of trends.
Cerda said the 60-day no-refusal initiative is not to arrest more people, but simply to deter those who think about drinking and driving.
Have a plan as to how you're going to get home without driving and without risking not only your life, but the life of everybody else that's driving out there that aren't intoxicated.
This is Timothy Chapman for Vaquero Radio.
New attractions are coming to Gladys Porter Zoo as early as the summer of 2024. Fernanda Gonzalez has the story.
Construction on Gladys Porter Zoo's new Soaring Eagle Zipline is underway as part of the nonprofit organization's $30 million master plan, aimed to renovate the facility's signature structures and add attractions. Executive Director of Gladys Porter Zoo, Patrick Birchfield, spoke about the master plan project and how it will impact not only Brownsville, but the Rio Grande Valley.
Well, this is a really exciting project for the Gladys Porter Zoo because we're going to provide the citizens of Brownsville and the Rio Grande Valley with a vantage point that no one else has in the valley.
Deputy Director of Gladys Porter Zoo, Colette Adams, spoke about how the master plan came into place with early planning beginning in March of 2020.
The very first item to accomplish on that master plan is the completion of a Soaring Eagle zipline, which will be installed here for multiple purposes. One of the main ones being to attract a different demographic to the zoo and to the area.
She described the zipline as a comfortable ride with 2 seats and a seatbelt. Attendees will take from a ground level, going backwards up to 110 feet in the air. The zipline's trajectory will be across the zoo over several animal exhibits, reaching a high point where participants will be able to appreciate the Rio Grande and Mexico. Then they will return gaining speed. Adams explained the next step for the zoo's master plan is renovating Small World by making the attraction all-inclusive.
The next item is going to be completing an area of the zoo, completing the development of an area in the zoo, which is currently called La Huasteca. We plan to create an area where we can move the animals that are in Small World that we intend to keep in our collection to a lush outdoor area with large habitats so that we can then demolish Small World, which is outdated and sitting on unstable ground, causing a new reimagined Small World that is going to be all-inclusive.
After the renovation of Small World, the Camel exhibit will undergo a redevelopment and become the new home for the zoo's lions. Birchfield spoke about how the city of Brownsville was a key component for the revitalization of the zoo.
The city of Brownsville realizes that the Gladys Porter Zoo is kind of the crown jewel in the crown of Brownsville, and they've come to the realization that as the number one tourist attraction in this area, other than South Padre Island, it's time to reinvest in the zoo and revitalize the zoo.
Adams expressed that the zoo staff is looking forward to the renovation.
And we are so looking forward to all of the changes that are long in coming and will also just launch us off into the next 50 years.
This is Fernanda Gonzalez for Vaquero Radio.
NASA chose a solar system ambassador from the Rio Grande Valley. Pete Mendoza has the details.
UTRGV Associate Vice President of Research Operations, Thomas Spencer, was recently appointed as NASA's new solar system ambassador, where he will spread excitement about space exploration and missions throughout the Rio Grande Valley. According to the NASA website, a solar system ambassador is in charge of communicating the science and excitement of NASA's space exploration missions and discoveries with the people in their communities. Spencer said in his role, he will share the discoveries and missions of NASA to the Rio Grande Valley. He said one way to accomplish this is by having UTRGV faculty conduct a series of videos explaining space science.
Some of the things that we'll be doing in the next several months are recording a series of videos with faculty from UTRGV who are working in space science. And they'll be explaining their research and how their research is meaningful and impactful and how it can affect positively our community and humanity as a whole.
According to Spencer, the videos explaining faculty space research will assist in expanding and gaining the attention of a broader audience. He said the Valley is expected to undergo significant change in the following 10 years.
The Rio Grande Valley and UTRGV are set right now on the cusp of some amazing things. The next 10 years are going to be some really impressive changes in the Valley. I mean, we've got some amazing people in the Valley, and I really look forward to them, you know, doing some amazing things. And, you know, this is just one of the ways that we can get in front of those kids.
Spencer said he is in charge of helping faculty with research rewards as the Vice President of Research Operations.
I'm responsible for not only the day-to-day operations of research administration, but also the strategy of helping our faculty be effective in their ability to win and manage research awards. So research administration is pre-award. We help the faculty find and submit awards for external funding agencies.
He said he has worked under the UT system for over 21 years. Starting with UT Southwestern Medical Center in Dallas for 19 years. For more information about NASA operations and research, visit nasa.gov. This is Pete Mendoza for Vaquero Radio.
The Rio Valley Meat Butcher Shop from Harlingen can now call themselves two-time champions of the American Royal World Series of Barbecue Brisket Competition. Here's Timothy Chapman with the story.
488 teams competed in the American Royal World Series of Barbecue from September 27th to October 1st in Kansas City, with the Rio Grande Valley's own Fred Robles taking first place in the Brisket Open Contest. American Royal is a not-for-profit organization that hosts the annual competition. According to its website, the American Royal World Series of Barbecue is the largest barbecue contest in the world. Competitors from across the globe join in the competitions to be crowned the grand champion. The competitions consist of the Invitational Competition, Open Competition, Sides Competition, and Kids Q. Rio Valley Meat Butcher Shop is located in Harlingen and has previously won in the Brisket Competition in the American Royal World Series of Barbecue in 2017. In 2019, the local shop won the overall championship. Owner of Rio Valley Meat Butcher Shop, Fred Robles, expressed the feelings he felt with his family and friends when he found out he won the Brisket Competition last month.
just hearing Rio Valley Meet there at the end, I was sitting next to my wife, and a bunch of our friends from Texas were there as well. And man, you hear that and just hear all kinds of screaming and shouting and high-fiving and hugs and tears and all kinds of emotions running through at that point, man. It's super exciting, man, especially on a stage like that. That's the biggest stage in the world. So it's definitely an experience for sure.
Robles explained he goes into every contest wanting to do well, but tries to stay humble every time he competes because he just never knows what the judges are looking for on that particular day.
At the end of the day, what I want to do is turn in a product that I was really happy with, and once it's turned in, it's really all up to them.
Co-owner of Rio Valley Meat Butcher Shop, Yari Robles, said her husband does all the cooking, but she assists him any way she can, including adding the final touches to make the plate look presentable, as well as the final important step, which is taking the plate to the judges.
Some people might say, like, it's not a big deal, right? You're just going to turn in the plate. But there's a whole thing, like, there's a whole stress behind it, because if I don't make it on time, they don't accept our tray. So it's kind of like that's half the battle, right? Just actually getting there and turning it in.
She expressed how proud the family is of her husband's accomplishments.
You know, it's a great feeling of when you win, right? It's great. And so the kids like to brag about their dad, and they'll tell their friends, like, yeah, like, Google my dad's name, right? And a bunch of pictures come up, you know, of all the contests that he's won. So, you know, we are very proud of him, and we hope that he knows that.
The next competition Rio Valley Meat Butcher Shop is expected to compete in will be the Briscoe Ranch Barbecue Cook-Off from December 8th to 9th in Uvalde, Texas. To see the final results of the 2023 American Royal World Series of Barbecue, visit AmericanRoyal.com. This is Timothy Chapman for Vaquero Radio.
The South Texas Health System has built a new program to help fight addictions and improve mental health in Edinburgh. Pete Mendoza has the details.
The new Chemical Dependency Unit is a self-admission program targeting substance addictions such as alcohol and drugs and the mental issues that come with them. Director of Clinical Services and the Program Director for the Substance Use Program, Yvette Bueno, said the unit runs through multiple steps.
Our psychiatrist here does meet with them, provides them the medication they need to safely detox them from whichever substance they're trying to detox from. But then their care goes into the rehabilitation portion, which we follow a curriculum through the Hazelton.
She said Hazelden has a holistic approach when it comes to drug addiction. The curriculum provides education on drug substances and how they affect the body, mental health, and overall well-being. It also shows how to build health support systems and networks to overcome addictions. She said the program will have a licensed chemical dependency counselor who gives treatments to an assigned unit. Bueno added the program will also have a licensed master social worker to assist with a more mental approach, especially since many of the patients fall into addiction due to hard times in their lives, which could include financial issues, stressors, relationship issues, homelessness, and many more difficulties. She said self-admission shows commitment to the program.
Usually the first step is the hardest step into recovery. It's, you know, having to one, admit that we have a problem. And so once we've come to terms with that and you're able to admit to yourself that whatever substance you're using is the problem and is affecting your daily life, then that just makes everything else a little bit easier.
According to American Addiction Centers, Hispanic Americans are the fastest growing population in America. An estimated 7.1% of Hispanic Americans are dealing with substance use issues. Bueno said the program is showing great progress and a lot of interest from the community, especially since most people seeking rehabilitation used to have to go upstate for these services.
When this project was in the beginning stages of it, that's what our community was in need of, right? A local inpatient rehab facility that can offer the services that we are offering. Prior to us, I think the closest one that we had was like in Corpus.
She said the Hispanic community usually never asks for help because of its culture. However, whenever someone does, it'll only be with family. So when patients are sent upstate, they are removed from a key part of their rehabilitation. Bueno said at the moment the program only has 10 beds, but will be seeking an additional 10 by the end of the month to further expand the unit. She said, unfortunately, since it is a new program, only insured individuals are able to be part of it. However, she is hoping to expand to private pay or be able to help uninsured patients. For more information about alcohol and drug addictions, visit South Texas Health System Behavioral.com. This is Pete Mendoza for Vaquero Radio.
And McLean goes up and throws down a monster dunk. That fires up the UTRGV field house.
Now time for Vaquero Sports.
Vaquero Baseball is practicing for perfection during this offseason. Here is the one and only Kevin Alemán with more details.
The UTRGV baseball team is hitting the field and getting the practice they need to prepare for their upcoming season in February. The offseason is about building chemistry and culture for the team and improving gameplay offensively and defensively. Senior infielder Cade York is a returner for the Vaqueros. The previous season, York was a key player defensively. York spoke about how he is trying to improve his offensive game.
My strikeouts last year were kind of high, so that's what I've been working on this offseason, turning my offense around for this next season.
The Vaqueros' overall record for the 2023 season was 30-26. With newcomers on the team, new talent comes into play. Head coach Derek Matlock explained the competition in starting positions and the bullpen.
We work really hard with our bullpen. We got so many guys fighting for the starting rotation. Once we get those guys established in the early spring, then we'll end up bumping those guys to the bullpen. But we got 8-9 guys fighting for four spots.
Preparing for the upcoming season allows individuals to work on their weaknesses and improve their strengths. Junior catcher Steven Lancia spoke about what he has been working on to grow this offseason.
Definitely getting stronger in the weight room. That's been a big thing for us as a whole team. And then just coming out here and just putting the pieces together, like figuring out which guys sit in which place, and so we can come out on the field and play as like one team.
Matlock previews the Vaqueros' expectations next year as the season starts in February.
I think you're going to see a lot more of the loss. You know, we've had 6 or 7 guys go to 95 plus. I think we got some speed too. There's some speed heading in there.
For more information, visit goutrgv.com. This is Kevin Alemán for Vaquero Radio.
Good morning, Vaqueros. It is time for your sports schedule of the week. At 6:30 p.m. Wednesday, November 29th, the UTRGV men's basketball team will face off against Grand Canyon University in the UTRGV Edinburgh Fieldhouse. Later that same evening at 8 p.m., the UTRGV women's basketball team will take on Grand Canyon University in Phoenix, Arizona. This is Timothy Chapman, and that was your sports schedule of the week.
And now for this week's events calendar.
Hello, Vaqueros. This is Ruben Cintora, and these are the events for the week. The Society of Automotive Engineers will be holding a Baja snack bar from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. on Monday, November 27th at the Engineering Building. The Center of Student Involvement will be giving free coffee out from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. on Tuesday, November 28th at the University Center. Make sure to bring your student ID for some free coffee. The Pre-Physician Association will be holding a Corn in a Cup fundraiser from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. on Wednesday, November 29th at the Library Barbecue Area.
And now for this week's Campus Weather Report.
Good morning, Vaqueros. I'm Joseph Zambrano with this week's Valley Weather Report. We're looking at a chilly first few days of the week, with Monday especially peaking at 55 degrees and going down to 50 degrees. Thursday will be much warmer, with a nice high of 80 degrees and a low of 66 degrees. Expect cloudy skies throughout the week and showers on Wednesday, with a 60% chance of rain in the afternoon. As always, look out for that humidity and cool weather that comes with such heavy precipitation. I'm Joseph Zambrano, and that was this week's Valley Weather Report.
That is the newscast for this week.
Don't forget to check our columns where you can read the opinion of our staff on anything and everything. You can also read our news stories on our website, utrgvradio.com.
Make sure to download the Radio FX app and listen to your favorite DJ shows by favoriting Vaquero Radio. Check out our YouTube channel so you can watch our newscasts and have the latest news from UTRGV.
Hi, I'm Jared Palomares.
Hi, I'm Alba Cantu from KBAQ-TV. Watch us Monday through Friday on social media or Vicas monitors around campus.
You can also catch us at utrgvtv.com.
Extra, extra!
Extra, extra!
You can also read the Writer newspaper by picking up a copy from the newsstands located around the university or on their website at utrgvwriter.com.
Don't forget to pick up your copy of Pulse Magazine, Issue 8, at our Edinburgh and Brownsville stands.
Or visit our website at www.utrgvpulse.com.
Pulse Magazine, by students, for students, about students.
Our weekly newscast will also be broadcasted every Wednesday at 10 a.m.
Join us next week, same time, same place.
Only on Vaquero Radio, the Valley Student Station.
This has been Vaquero Radio News, the Valley Student Station.